his wife to stand here. Just let his wife do it. Just let his wife. One day we're gonna enter to those pearly gates. No one is ever gonna have the Jews coming to us.
Hallelujah. Verse number 17. You find it? Just say, I'm there. Can we read together verse number 17? Also I set watchmen over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. But they say, we will not hearken. They say, we will not hearken. Many of our churches today are at a crossroad, trying to make a decision as to which way to turn. Some has already made the wrong turn because they have listened to some liberal theologian who has informed them that we are living in modern times. And the old formula is no good. Unrighteousness today is more than righteousness. And because of that, nature is reacting. That's why we're having all the hurricanes and the earthquakes and the violence and the gang wars. When unrighteousness supersede righteousness, the earth begins to shake. Ladies and gentlemen, I have come to realize it is not the world that is teaching people to rebel against God. It is the church. It has become fashionable to sin today. We must remember that our fathers, the men of old, the mothers of old, who steered a straight course, were not men and women who compromised. I will admit they did not know everything. But I may submit to you today that they were men and women of principle. Principle was paramount in their lives. Conscience was a sacred thing. And above all, they